Now we are going to determine the transport number of an ion, either cation or anion, using a method that is commonly used method for determining the transport number is Hittorf method. So according to Hittorf, he has used this device to calculate the transport number, determine the transport number experimentally. So according to this device, if you observe this device, we can see here there are three glass tubes. In the middle, it is showing U-shaped glass tube connected to two glass bulbs. U-shaped glass tube is connected to two glass bulbs. So left side it is connected to anodic compartment, right side it is connected to cathodic compartment. And this whole apparatus is connected to a voltammeter that is usually called as silver voltammeter. So in this compartment, it is connected to positively charged electrode, therefore this is called as anodic compartment, this is cathodic compartment, between it is having middle compartment. So whichever the electrolyte for which we are going to calculate the transport number is taken in this device. So we are filled this device with an electrolyte, for which we are going to determine the transport number. So by calculating the following concentration around the anodic compartment and weight deposited in the voltammeter using the Hittorf device, by substituting them in this equation, we will get the transport number of cation. So how do we get the following concentration around the anodic compartment? In order to calculate the transport number of cation, initially we are calculating the weight of cation before the electrolysis in anodic compartment, let it be X. And after the electrolysis, we are calculating the weight of cation in anodic compartment, let it be Y. So what happened here? We will get the falling concentration around anodic compartment. Anodic compartment, that is equals to X minus Y. Usually, before the electrolysis, the number of cations in the anodic compartment is high when we compare it to the number of cations in the anodic compartment after the electrolysis. So, the falling concentration around the anodic compartment is X minus Y. At the same time, the weight deposited in voltammeter, that is, we are using here silver voltammeter. So, the weight deposited in silver voltammeter, let it be Z. So, by this, we can say that the transport number of cation is equals to X minus Y by Z. So in this way, we can calculate the transport number of cation using Hittorf method. Once we know the transport number for a cation, from the Hittorf method, we can calculate the transport number of other ion by using this equation. That means 1 minus X minus Y by Z. In case one, that is, if you use the inert electrodes, we are going to calculate the transport number in this manner. If you use attackable electrodes, for example, silver electrode is utilized in this anodic compartment, what happens here? The silver electrode will also involve in the reaction. So in that situation, case two, that is attackable electrodes, we have to adopt another formula for calculating the transport number of a cation or anion. So in this situation, what happens generally when we use the silver electrode in this situation, after the migration of cation towards cathodic compartment, anion towards anodic compartment, what happens here? The unpaired anions will react with the silver electrode and get deposited. The two silvers will be deposited. While discharge of these two anions, the two silver ions will be reacted with the silver electrode and two cations will be deposited in this anodic compartment. So during the electrolysis, if at all the electrode involves in the reaction, what happens? Instead of decreasing the concentration of cation, there is an increase in the concentration of cations in the anodic compartment, because here the electrode has involved in the reaction with the electrolyte. So let us assume Let the weight of the cation in anode compartment before electrolysis is x grams, after the electrolysis is y grams. So what happened here? The weight has been increased here. That increased in weight in the anode compartment, let it be y minus x. So if at all there is no migration of cation, there is no migration of cation from the anodic compartment, then this increase in the anodic compartment must be equals to the weight deposited in the silver voltammeter. But what happened practically here? The weight deposited in the silver voltammeter is somewhat high. That means the difference between the weight deposited in the silver voltammeter and the increase in the weight of the cation in the anodic compartment is nothing but it is due to the fall in concentration at the anodic compartment due to the cation migration. So the fall in concentration of cation at the anodic compartment due to the cation migration can be calculated as like this, Z minus of Y minus X. So therefore the transport number can be written as Z minus Y minus X by Z. The formula for calculating the transport number, in case 1 we are using the previous formula. So in this way we can calculate the transport number using the Hittorf method.